Dr. Waisman, University of Wisconsin. These are my two patients, Keith and Kay. Both children were diagnosed as having phenylketonuria.
Oh, my memories are very happy with him.
The important point is to detect phenylketonuria early. And I think that's why Kay is as good as she is today.
What I remember most about that filming day is that he kept forgetting his lines, and that's probably why I was kind of restless and stuff, because it kind of took a while. I'm the first successfully treated in the state of Wisconsin, and one of the first successfully treated in the United States.
I'm Susan Highway.
Hi, Kay. How are you?
Oh, really good.
Good to see you.
I'm a nurse practitioner and a clinical professor at the Waisman Center, the University of Wisconsin-Madison. So what's really nice is that I don't see very much tremor.
No.
So today was a clinic appointment for Kay Emerson.
How many times?
The dietitian Nikki Drilius was with me today. We also have a medical director. We have genetic counselors that work with us, and we follow these individuals in a team approach across their lifespan. And before Dr. Waisman's work, individuals with PKU were not treated, and resulted in having significant intellectual disability.
Without him, I wouldn't have become the person I am.
Kay is a fortunate individual that has been able to live an independent life.
Around that same time, he and others developed the dietary approach to managing and preventing the negative effects of PKU. And he found that by putting an infant on a special diet that restricted the intake of certain proteins, it prevented the negative effects of PKU.
I love to cook. So I was put on the diet right away. It was very hard when I was a pioneer on the diet. They had very little food. There was no medical foods like there is now. I tell kids now, you guys have it easy.
But the professional responsibility and social responsibility of all physicians who see children.
So Dr. Waisman was a public policy advocate, and he advocated for a program to be implemented of mandatory newborn testing, meaning that every baby who is born is tested for genetic diseases. And today, we have gone from testing for PKU, one genetic disease, to about 40 genetic diseases. And this is implemented all over the United States.
It's huge for society because the cost of supporting individuals who have intellectual disabilities is pretty high. And for individuals who can function independently, they can give back to society.
I have a Facebook page, Kay Marie's PKU World.
So she's really taken it on, and it's given her meaning in her life to give back.
I work very hard at helping other PKUers go on the diet. I've been rescuing PKUers onto the diet, and I work very hard at helping them because I feel that he worked very hard to get me on the diet. You know, it's even after he passed away, I know where his marker is. I would go there after graduation, just before I graduated high school, after I graduated college, just before I got married, when I became engaged. I'd go there and talk with him. He may not still be here, but you know, there's a part of Dr. Waisman that will always live in my parents' life and in my life.